Hello, welcome again. We are solving GATE 2022 Mechanical Engineering Paper 1. If A is matrix 10, 2k plus 5, 3k minus 3, k plus 5, elements of matrix, is a symmetric matrix, then the value of k is option A 8, option B 5, option C minus 0.4, option D 1 plus root 1561, you are at 12. Okay, so for a symmetric matrix, the matrix and its transpose should be equal. Okay, and the transpose of this matrix is 10, 3k minus 3, 2k plus 5, and k plus 5. Okay, so these two should be equal, and quoting the element of these, so this 10 is equal to 10, so this 2k plus 5 is equal to 3k minus 3. Or 2k plus 5 is equal to 3k minus 3, so k is here 8. Option A is the right answer. Okay. Next, a uniform light slender beam AB of section modulus EI is pinned by a frictionless joint A to the ground and supported by a light inextensible cable CB to hang a weight W as shown. If the maximum value of W to avoid buckling of the beam AB is obtained as beta pi square EI, where pi is the ratio of circumference to diameter of the circle, then the value of beta is, so this is the diagram given, and the value of beta is option A 0.0924 meter per square, and option B 0.073713 meter minus 2, option C 0.1261 meter minus 2, and option D 0.1417 meter minus 2. Okay, so this is your load W, and this is your load W, and so it is causing tension T in the string and force FAB in this pin jointed member. Okay, so if we resolve the forces vertically, then its vertical number will be T cos T sin 30, because this angle is 30, and it is balanced by W, so T will be your 2W. Okay, now if we resolve the forces horizontally, then FAB will be equal to T cos 30, and T is 2W, so FAB will be here 2W root 3 by 2, or FAB will be here root 3 by 2. Okay, now this is your pin jointed end. Okay, and to avoid buckling in pin jointed end, the load should be, FAB should be pi square EI by L square, and L is 2.5. okay, so equating this 1 and 2, because W is given as B beta pi square EI, and FAB is your root 3W, so FAB will be your root 3 pi square I, pi square EI into beta. So equating and this is a buckling load. Okay, so equating these two, will get the value of beta, because EI will cancel, pi square will cancel, out, and so we will have beta is equal to 1 by root 3 2.5 square. So answer will be 0.092376 meter per square. Option 1 is the right answer. Next, the figure shows a schematic of a simple Watt governor mechanism with the spindle O1 O2 rotating at an angular velocity omega about a vertical axis. The balls at P and S have equal mass. Assume that there is no friction anywhere and all other components are massless and rigid. The vertical distance between the horizontal plane of rotation of balls and the pivoted O1 is denoted by h. The value of h is equal to 400 mm at a certain omega. If omega is double, then the value of h will be dash mm. Options are a is equal to 50, b is equal to 100, c is equal to 150, d is equal to 200. Okay. So now this is your Watt burner, and considering half of the configuration, so the forces acting are, if it is rotating, then a centrifugal force will act and add it. Weight of the ball will act, so centrifugal force is m omega square r and weight is mg. So this is taking moment out this point, so we will have fc into h, okay, clockwise, and mg into r. So omega square is equal to gh, or omega is equal to root gh. Okay, now we can see that omega is directly proportional to 1 by root h. Okay, now if omega is doubled, we have derived the expression for omega in Watt Gordner. If omega is doubled, then suppose h1 be the new height attained, because when omega is doubled, the centrifugal force will take this ball to the left. Okay, so h will change. So now new h is your h1. Okay, so from 1 and 2, 2 omega by omega is root h by root h1. Okay, so h1 will be your 100 mm. So putting the value of h as 400, so h1 will be your 100 mm. So this will shift by, so this will decrease because of shifting of this. So it will be 100 mm. Next, a square threaded screw is used to lift a load W by applying a force F. Efficiency of square threaded screw is expressed as, option A, the ratio of work done by W per revolution to work done by F per revolution. Option B, W by F. Option C, F by W. Option D, the ratio of work done by F per revolution to work done by W per revolution. Efficiency is output work by input work, and output work is done by the load to be lifted, or so the work done by W per revolution, and input work is the force applied per revolution, or work done per, work done by force applied per revolution. So it is work done F by F per revolution. So answer is, the ratio of work done by W per revolution to work done by F per revolution. So answer is option A.